I need a canoe paddle so that I can test my canoe. And I use the scrap materials I have to make this paddle. I'm not trying to make a very fancy paddle, just something that will work for my trip. The length of the handle of the paddle should be measured from the top of the chair all the way to my eye level, and it turned out to be 29 inches. The length of the blade can be between 24 to 26 inches. The width of the blade can be between 6 to 8 inches. I cut 2 sheets of cobblest. They are 26 inches long and 8 inches wide. The channels of the first sheet is oriented horizontally. Then I cut the second sheet and the channels are oriented vertically. I fused the top part of 2 sheets together to form a pocket. And then I inserted the Y-shaped PVC pipe, which is the handle. The Y-shape will allow the pipe to stay in place after I fuse both sheets together. Finally, I fused the bottom part of the pocket and completed the assembly. I trimmed off the edges and make it look more like a paddle. This is the first time I use heat fusion to build a paddle. I added a T-coupler to the end of the pipe. The overall length of the PVC pipe is 54 inches. I recycled the cobblest from my old boat and used it for the blade. I cut 2 sheets and they are 26 inches by 8 inches. And they are 6 millimeter thick cobblest. I used a 3/4 inch diameter PVC pipe and I have to determine at which point I want to make the pipe thinner or tapered. I cut a few cylindrical blocks and I inserted them to both ends of the pipe to prevent water from getting into the pipe. I cut one end of the PVC pipe for about 5 inches deep and then I use heat gun to flatten it and make it into a Y shape. After you heat up the pipe and apply the force to compress the pipe, you have to keep on compressing it until the PVC pipe cools down, otherwise it will not retain in the shape you want it to be in. I stack the cobblest sheet together and allow about 1/4 inch of the cobblest sticking out from the plywood. Then I apply heat and melt the 1/4 inches of cobblest. I compressed the melted cobblest with another sheet of plywood so that I can create a good joint between the two cobblest. I repeat this step and completed fusing the whole edge. Two sheets are partially fused at the edge and I flip it over and determine where I should place the PVC pipe. I apply a lot of heat along the edges. Remember, I have to use wood pieces when I press down. Do not use your finger, otherwise you will create fingerprints on the cobblest. I do the same on the other side of the cobblest. I have to create a pocket for the PVC pipe. Then I shoot a lot of heat into the gap. It's okay to shoot more heat. You have to pay attention to the placement of the pipe while you are fusing the corpus together. And also the heat applied to corpus will also affect the PVC pipe. And you have to keep the pipe in a straight line while the whole unit being cooled down. I used a slightly bigger corpus sheet to make this paddle so that I can trim off the excess corpus if I want to. I run my finger over the edge of the blade. If I feel there's a sharp corner, I will apply heat and melt the surface slightly, and then use the glove to smooth it off to remove that sharp edge. It took me about an hour to make this paddle. I believe it will work for me. If you find this video useful, please give me a like or subscribe to my channel. Help me to grow my channel. I appreciate that. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.